Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial online classes. This is Ring Theory class number 33. In this class we discuss about very important theorem, fundamental theorem of homomorphism of rings. Fundamental theorem of homomorphism of rings. The statement of the theorem is, let capital R comma R dash be two rings and F maps capital R into R dash be a homomorphism with kernel U, then R bar is isomorphic to R by U. R bar is isomorphic to R by U. What is R bar? Homomorphic image. The homomorphic image of the function F is isomorphic to R by U. What is R by U? Quotient ring. So to prove this statement, let us write the analysis of this statement first. We write the analysis. Let us start. Let capital R comma R dash be two rings. Let capital R comma R dash be two rings. And 0 belongs to capital R. 0 dash belongs to R dash. Be zero elements. Observe that. 0 belongs to R. 0 dash belongs to R dash. Be zero elements. And let are given that F maps capital R into R dash be a homomorphism. Be a homomorphism with kernel F. With kernel F is equals to U. It means U is the kernel of the homomorphism. That is, U is equals to kernel F is equals to set of those elements X belongs to capital R such that F of X is equals to 0 dash. F of X is equals to 0 dash. Very clear. Here this kernel R U is subset to R. By definition of kernel, kernel is always subset to the domain capital R. Next, R bar is the homomorphic image. Here, R bar is equals to the set of all images F of X such that X belongs to capital R is the homomorphic image. Homomorphic image of capital R under F. R by U, the set R by U is known as quotient ring. The set R by U, which is set of all cosets X plus U such that X belongs to capital R, is the quotient ring with respect to coset addition A plus U plus B plus U is equals to A plus B plus U. A plus U into B plus U is equals to AB plus U. For all A plus U comma B plus U belongs to R by U. What it is? That is, this is the introduction part of the theorem. We analyze the terminology of the statement. F maps capital R into R dash be a homomorphism. And F with kernel U. Then R bar is isomorphic to R by U. So let us take some another conditions. What is zero element of R by U? What is unity element of R by U? The zero element of R by U is here. zero element of R by U is 0 plus U. Unity element of R by U. We don't need to write the unity element, so leave it. 0 element of R by U is 0 plus U, which is also equivalent to U. Take F is on to also. Take F is on to. If F is on to, then R bar is equals to. Then take F is on to. Then F of R bar is equals to R dash. Then R bar is equals to F of R is equals to R dash. Take F is onto. Then R bar is equals to F of R is equals to R dash. Whenever function is onto, the range is equals to codomain. Here R bar is the range or homomorphic image of capital R. Yes. This is the introduction part of the theory 2. R bar is isomorphic to R by U. That is, to prove this, define a mapping. Pi maps R by U into R bar. By pi of A is equals to A plus U. To prove that R is isomorphic to R bar is isomorphic to R by U. Define a mapping pi maps R by U into R bar by pi of A plus U is equals to F of A for all A plus U belongs to R by U. Observe this. We have to prove that R bar is isomorphic to R by U. That is, R bar is isomorphic to R by U. Define a mapping pi maps R by U into R bar by pi of A plus U is equals to F of A for all A plus U belongs to R by U. In view of this mapping, you can write pi of X plus U is equals to F of X. Pi of Y plus U is equals to F of Y. F of 2 plus U is equals to F of 2. So, in view of this mapping, you can use like this. You can write like this. So, first we show that this mapping is well defined. First we show that pi is well defined. To prove that pi is well defined. Suppose let us take any two elements A plus U is equals to B plus U. For A plus U, comma B plus U belongs to R by U. Which implies as A plus U is equals to B plus U means A minus B belongs to U. Because U is kernel. Every kernel is an ideal. By using ideal properties, A minus B belongs to U. If A minus B belongs to U and U is kernel, we have F of A minus B is equals to 0 dash. F is a homomorphism. By applying the definition of homomorphism, you have F of A minus F of B is equals to 0 dash, which implies F of A is equals to F of B. What is f of a? By definition of pi, what is f of a? Pi of a plus u. Is a equals to pi of b plus u. Therefore, we take a plus u is equals to b plus u. We prove that pi of a plus u is equals to pi of b plus u. Therefore, pi is well defined. Therefore, pi is well defined. You observe this concept. Very, very important one. We define a mapping pi of a plus u is equals to f of a. Whether the mapping is right or wrong, is it possible to define a mapping in this way? Let us check out. Suppose a plus u is equals to b plus u. U is a kernel of the mapping. Kernel of the homomorphism is an ideal. By applying the definition of ideal, a plus u is equals to b plus u implies a minus b belongs to u. U is kernel, therefore f of a minus b is equals to 0 dash. F of a minus f of b is equals to 0 dash. Because f is a homomorphism, f of a is equals to f of b. By definition of pi, f of a is equals to pi of a plus u. So we write pi of a plus u is equals to pi of b plus u. Therefore, the mapping pi is well defined. Yes, it is very clear. The mapping pi is well defined. Next we prove that pi is 1, 1. The mapping pi is 1, 1. Yes. Next side heading. To prove that pi is 1, 1. To prove that pi is 1, 1. Suppose pi of a plus u is equals to pi of b plus u. For a plus u comma b plus u belongs to R by u. You observe that. Suppose pi of a plus u is equals to pi of b plus u. For a plus u comma b plus u belongs to R by u. 1, 1 function is nothing but the converse of the well-defined. By definition of pi, pi of a plus u can be written as f of a. Pi of b plus u can be written as f of b. Which implies f of a minus f of b is equals to 0 dash. Which implies f of a minus b is equals to 0 dash. Which implies a minus b belongs to kernel u. Which implies if a minus b belongs to kernel u, then a plus u is equals to b plus u. Therefore, we take that pi of a plus u is equals to pi of b plus u implies as a plus u is equals to b plus u. Therefore, pi is 1, 1. In the well-defined part, we take this one. A plus u is equals to b plus u. We prove that pi of a plus u is equals to pi of b plus u. So you observe that these two are converses to one another. To prove that pi is 1, 1, to prove that pi is well defined are converses to each other. Yes. In the next step, we prove that pi is onto. To prove that pi is onto. What is the definition of onto? Every element of the codomain has at least one pre-image in the domain. What is onto function? Every element of codomain has at least one pre-image in the domain. Here, the codomain of pi is R bar. Since pi maps R by u into R bar. Pi maps R by u into R bar. R bar is the codomain. Let us take an element y belongs to R bar. If y belongs to R bar, then there exists an element x belongs to capital R such that f of x is equals to y. then there exists an element x belongs to capital R such that f of x is equals to y. Because f is onto, you observe that in the introduction part we take f is onto. In the introduction part we take f is onto. Therefore, whenever y belongs to R bar, there exists an element x belongs to capital R such that f of x is equals to y. Now you observe that since x belongs to R implies as x plus u belongs to R by u. And by definition of pi, pi of x plus u is equals to f of x. By definition of pi, pi of x plus u is equals to f of x. What is f of x? Y. Therefore, you observe that y belongs to R bar, codomain. There exists an element x plus u belongs to R by u, which is known as domain, such that pi of x plus u, is equals to y. For every element y belongs to codomain, there exists an element x plus u belongs to domain such that pi of x plus u is equals to y. Therefore, you observe that pi is onto function. You remember that here pi becomes an onto function because of only f is onto. So that's why we take in the introduction the function f maps capital R into R dash is an onto function. Yes, next third one, we have to prove that pi is a homomorphism. We prove that already pi is well defined and pi is a 1-1 function and pi is an onto function also. Now we prove that pi is a homomorphism. To prove that pi is a homomorphism, let us take any two elements. A plus u, b plus u belongs to R by u. And now, pi of a plus u plus b plus u is equals to pi of addition of cosets. A plus u plus b plus u is equals to a plus b plus u. And definition of pi, f of a plus b. F is a homomorphism. F of a plus f of b. F of a, pi of a plus u. F of b, pi of b plus u. Therefore, we prove that pi of a plus u plus b plus u is equals to pi of a plus u plus pi of b plus u, which is the first property of homomorphism. In the definition of homomorphism, we learn that f of x plus y is equals to f of x plus f of y. So here pi of a plus u plus pi of b plus u is equals to pi of a plus u plus pi of b plus u. Therefore, we conclude that pi satisfies the first property of homomorphism. And second property, pi of a plus u into b plus u is equals to product of cosets, multiplication of cosets, pi of a b plus u. By definition of pi, f of a b, f is a homomorphism, f of a into f of b. What is f of a? Pi of a plus u. What is f of b? Pi of b plus u. Therefore, we prove that pi of a plus u into b plus u is equals to pi of a plus u into pi of b plus u for all a plus u comma b plus u belongs to R by u. From this calculation we conclude that therefore pi is a homomorphism. Now you observe that we prove that pi is a 1-1 function, pi is an onto function and pi is a homomorphism. So finally, we conclude that Therefore, phi maps R by U into R bar is a 1-1 function and is onto function and it satisfies the homomorphism condition also is homomorphism. We know that any function satisfying these three conditions is known as an isomorphism. Therefore, pi maps R by U into R bar is an isomorphism. Is an isomorphism. If pi is an isomorphism, then we conclude that R by U is isomorphic to R bar. Therefore, R by U is isomorphic. R by U is isomorphic to R bar. In notations, R by U is isomorphic to R bar. This completes the proof. This is one of the very, very important theorem for your examination. And also we solve some problems depends upon this theorem. Practice this theorem and write the proof in your own words also and understand the concepts of 1-1, onto and homomorphism. And also you learn the addition and multiplication of cosets. It is very useful to you to prove this theorem.